All right. Hi, everyone. If you guys are standing behind the cameraman, come on in. We've got some really cool things to talk about. My name's Lori Corbin. I'm the food and fitness coach for Channel 7 in Los Angeles, the ABC station. And I still teach fitness and I do nutrition stuff. So I'm really excited about being with these guys because they do something that we all want to know about. And these are the tracking systems that are available now, you know, via sometimes clothing or armbands or whatever, and everything hooks up to your smartphone. And everybody here is doing something different. So I don't want to take it my time about me. I really want to introduce these guys. I'm each going to have them tell their name, what they're doing, and a little bit about themselves, and then we'll get into the heart of it about what they're actually really doing that you'll yourself probably want to get into. Some of it's even free. So this is Adam. Take it away, Adam.
I'm Adam Rosante, and I'm the founder of the People's Boot Camp and WaveShape, neither of which are tracking applications. They're actually fitness classes. So I'm a fitness trainer and a healthy living expert, and the folks from Health Interactive asked me if I could come and speak on this panel because I'm actually seeing people put the things that these guys have created into use every day. And you know, my opinions on whether or not I actually find that to be effective, whether I find it to be overwhelming, a complete waste of time, or worth every penny. So, you know, I'll let these guys dive into it and then, you know, potentially tear them apart.
Nadim, you go.
Can't wait.
Just kidding.
My name is Nadim Kassam. I'm the founder of a company called Basis and a company called BioBeats. Founded Basis in 2004. It's a device that sits on your wrist, picks up all kinds of cool stuff. I'll tell you about it in a little bit, including my heart rate, which is high as usual on stage. I spent about 7 years in R&D, raised $7-8 million there. I went to Silicon Valley, raised another $40 million, and tried to build a device company. Got sick of it and started building a software company. I'll tell you more about that.
Chris, you go.
Hi, everyone. I'm Chris Downey, the founder and CEO of sparkpeople.com. Our mission is to spark millions of people to reach their goals. And today I'm going to tell you a little bit about this little thing called the Spark Activity Tracker.
Dan?
Hi, Dan Conroy. I'm head of business development for CarePass, which is a platform for aggregating your different information across many mobile health apps. Excited to tell you about it.
So the whole idea here is to have them tell us more in depth. Some of them have some videos, some have them slides. So it kind of gives you that in depth, do I want this, why do I want it, and how's it really going to work for me? And there's so many things out there that sound good, but are they really user friendly? So it's kind of fun. So, and obviously Adam's going to say, you know, being in fitness, when you see people, is this tracking really helping us? Is it just sort of a lesson in futility? These guys are saying, heck no, you know, it really does help you be a better whoever you want to be. So we're going to have Nadim. He's got a couple things going. The BioBeat thing is cool. I actually downloaded it, and you can put your finger on a phone, and it, you know, it's really cool. But he's got some good stuff. So take it away.
Sure. So I'm going to start with Basis because I founded that way too early. So in 2004, I saw this movement coming of tracking your activity, but I was very fascinated with the heart. And not just the heart in the form of getting your heart rate up for fitness, but what happens to your heart when you relax, when you try and meditate, when you enter a drum circle, what happens on the dance floor. I believe all of those things are healthy activities, if you can make them that way. And so I got fascinated with visualizing my heart. There was nothing on the market that allowed you to do that. Everything required a chest strap and fitness, or Holter monitors with leads all over your body. And ended up creating this. This is called the Basis Band. It looks really cool. I'll show you why. It's on my wrist. It's got 5 sensors inside of it. On the back, you see an optical sensor picking up your heart all day, not just heart rate, but all of your heartbeats. Inside of it as well is an accelerometer. You'll see galvanic skin response sensors on it, as well as temperature sensors. So there's 5 sensors inside, giving you a really cool picture of your sleep, your activity, and all kinds of cool stuff that's coming. I then founded a company called BioBeats. Basis grew pretty large. I'm a kind of a startup guy. Basis is in San Francisco. I wanted to come to LA and meet with cool people. So I started a company called BioBeats. I believe that the information in your body is very unique and it can be turned into music. This might be a good time for the video. Yeah, why don't we do the video?
Hello, everybody tuning in right now. The Far East Movement is here.
Place your finger over the light and camera of your phone. BioBeats will display your heartbeat. You and everyone around the world will be contributing your heartbeat, which will be shown visually during the live broadcast.
We are trying to reach 1 million heartbeats. So please donate your heartbeats to this experiment. It's for a great cause. We're merging biometrics with music.
Yes,
for the
y'all.
First time ever.
Hands in the air. Turn it up now. Let me see y'all dance. Yeah. Get it poppin', hot tamale. Dirty face, we're so bad about it. Too legit, we can't quit the party. Super freaks, no Illuminati. So, 1, 2, hit the booms, we on YouTube. Nothing to lose, so let it loose. Cause the sheep don't sleep like ba, 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 ba. Yeah, drop low to the L-O.
L-O.
B-E gotta get low.
Get low.
So clap your hands, clap, clap your hands. I got nothing but love to give.
Turn it up.
Turn it up, you don't hit me low.
Hit me low.
Here's the love for your stereo.
Stereo.
Yo, so clap your hands, clap, clap your hands. I got nothing but love to give.
We are one tonight, and we're breathing in the same air. So turn up the love, turn up the love. We're turning up the love. We are one tonight, and we're breathing in the
same. How many did we hit? How many heartbeats?
1.5 million. That's a lot of love.
Yeah.
That's a lot of
love.
You can kill that video. So my vision is to merge entertainment and healthcare. That video, that app you just saw is being used in all kinds of cool entertainment applications, but it's also in clinical trials in the UK to engage people with monitoring their health.
So you guys, what you kind of, there was a cool video, had a lot of music, but like you have an app, you press it, and when you press it, then your phone lights up and you put your finger over it, like where you're going to take a picture, and then suddenly you see your heartbeat. So I'm going to do that really quick for you because I think it kind of gets you excited. Okay, having everybody with their heartbeat together, that's kind of cool, but I know we're all selfish. Like, I want to know, you know, what I'm all about, right? So then I pick, because of my heartbeat, why it's not working for me, I don't know. But you're going, oh, Nadim, I'm sorry. Anyway, so maybe you can get it going. So you just press, put your finger over where it's gonna take picture, and then it shows you your heart beating. It's very cool. So, you know, in a way you can say, oh, I'm at 76 beats per minute or whatever, and pretty soon your phone starts playing a song. Now, that might be cool, like, in and of itself, but then, let's say you're all in an exercise class, that'd be kind of fun, like, turn off the music, and it all syncs up together, doesn't it?
It does.
So then all the songs, all the phones start playing the same song. Oh, can you see that? Yeah. Can you see him? So that's how it works. So he's going to put his finger right over the light there. Yes. I'll hold it up so the cameraman can see. There you go. And then, can you guys see that on the screen, how his finger, the heartbeat's going back and forth? Kind of, sort of. Show him. Show him. Yeah. It's kind of cool, huh? That's free, by the way.
Is your heart going up from the house music?
Yeah, it's going to go up. I see you sitting next to me. So it's an individual experience. It's a collective experience. It's an entertaining experience. And it's a healthy experience.
Okay. Thank you. Chris, what do you think?
Oh, I love it. But I can't sing and dance, so I'm going to try to tell a story instead.
Okay.
My story is, as a kid, I had anxiety. I didn't like it. So I put together a program that took the best of health and fitness on one side and the best of goal setting, motivation, and leadership on the other side. So it was like smashing together a personal trainer and a dietitian with a Stephen Covey or a Viktor Frankl. And it really, using this program, I set a goal to do a 10-minute workout, see how many days in a row I could do it. I ended up doing that 700 days in a row, and I had a coworker do the same thing, and she was overweight and depressed until she started this program. She did the program, she ended up losing 50 pounds and telling me that I changed her life, and she went on and started a walking group where there are all these people saying, Pat, if you can do it, we can do it. So I said, I realized that your daily actions and words impact more people than you'll ever realize, and said I was gonna start a company out of that. So after starting eBay's leading competitor because of all the energy from this program, I then sold that to eBay, started a new company called Spark People with the mission to spark millions of people to reach their goals. And on sparkpeople.com, we have four things. Interactive tracking tools like nutrition and fitness tracker. Second is content from experts, so articles, videos. Third is community, so our site gets millions of message board posts per month. And fourth is coaching, so we love helping people reach goals in all areas of life. We had a member get a two-book deal for more than $1 million after using the site. But what we just launched about a month ago takes that interactive tracking ability on the site and makes it automatic. So this is the Spark Activity Tracker. It clips to your shoe, to your belt, if you're a woman, to your bra. I forgot to wear mine today. And then what it does is it will measure your steps, calories burned, distance, and time, and integrate seamlessly with the sparkpeople.com experience on the web and on mobile. Some neat things about this are it's completely waterproof, so if you put it in the washer like I have before, it'll survive that. It has a 6 to 12 month battery life, so it's got some great features as a standalone device in terms of measuring. It also will measure if you are walking, running, or doing the elliptical, or whether you're doing like exercise bike. So it's got some really great features, but the best part is connecting it to this entire ecosystem on sparkpeople.com. So that's my story. I love helping people reach their goals, and if you want to check out our site, it's completely free, and then this is only $59.95.
So you guys, I don't know if you do Body Bug or Fitbit or whatever, but you know what I took out of that, which I love, was I have a battery that's charged for 6 months. Because did you ever try to take those things off, wash them, you know, whatever? You know, it's kind of neat that it's going to get wet, it's going to be fine, and it's going to stay with you for 6 months. That's a bonus, you know. I mean, when you look at what you're spending on some of these. And yours, I mean, some of them are what, 100, 150 bucks? Yours is what?
Right, just $59.95.
Okay, pretty cool. Dan?
Great, thank you. So CarePass just came out in June, and it's online and mobile. There's iOS and Android apps. And we are super excited to be working with many of the leading mobile health apps. So Spark People, for example, is a partner. And the goal of CarePass is really discovery. So you can learn more about yourself based on your engagement in multiple areas, fitness, nutrition, sleep, and so on. And you can also discover the different apps that will help motivate you to get to that next place. Maybe it's the Spark People device, maybe it's Lose It for nutrition tracking. It really runs the gamut. We have 25 different partners. And so the technical difficulties, sorry. So as an example, this is just a visual of the app where you have a fitness goal and the devices on the right, Body Media, Fitbit, et cetera, they all work to kind of populate your progress on the goal. And the apps on the left are other fitness tracking services that also work. And what we're trying to do is offer choice so that you can experiment and try and find the one that works for you. And also motivate yourself to kind of meet a bigger picture goal. In this case, it's a 215-mile goal. So it's something that's going to be done in a long time, not days, depending how active you are, I guess.
Is Chris's on there? Did I see Chris's?
Yes. Okay. Yes, Spark okay. People is on there as well.
Okay.
And so the last visual here I'll show, just in the interest of time, is really the dashboard view. So right now, it's very wellness-oriented. It's fitness, it's nutrition, it's sleep, trying to give you that snapshot of your health. But we're going to be adding new areas like medication adherence, mood, stress management, and ultimately the goal is to kind of connect the dots so you know how you're doing and in context how you're doing to people like you.
The neatest thing I saw about this when we were talking backstage was you go to your doctor and he says, what do you do? And you know, you just can't remember, like, did I eat that? Do I do that? When did I do that? Whatever. This is for you. You can actually show this to your healthcare provider, which I think is cool. Or let's say there's something that you don't want him to know. Maybe you go to acupuncture, you feel a little bit weird about that. But you didn't want to feel like sharing that with the rest of the world. It is what you want it to be. It is for you. So you're as honest as you are with yourself, obviously, with your data. But you also, if you are going to the physician or someone, you know, that's helping you with your health, no matter where it is, you can say, this is me in my sleep, this is me in my fitness, this is me wherever, and it's just a nice data holder, I believe, right?
Yeah, it's open for anybody, so yeah. You don't have to be an Aetna member, and if you are an Aetna member and would like to connect it to your Aetna account, it will pull in information from your personal health record so you can learn more insights. But it's all at choice is the mantra, so it's all at the individual level. You control the connections and who sees your information.
So Adam, fitness extraordinaire, you've taken a look. What is your verdict?
I think they're all great. To me, the single most important thing to me is that more people get moving every day, right? That's all that matters. And there are different things that motivate each one of us. And so I found in my career that he is amped up. Who wants to be in that class right now, right? I'm like sitting here talking about fitness tracking. Get up! Wave shape?
Awesome. Well,
awesome.
Oh, that's tough. Tough call.
Cool.
Why be in there when we can hear him in here?
So, to me, I found that there, the two biggest hurdles facing anybody looking to get in shape and stay in shape are, one, the ability to take action, right? And the willingness to maintain consistency. I mean, honestly, that's probably the two greatest hurdles facing any area of life. It's like, how many of you have that friend that's like, I'm going to start a cupcake business next year. I'm going to start that cupcake business. But they never get off their ass and do it, right? So the same thing applies to fitness. It's first taking action. And second is maintaining consistency. And I think that what all of these products have the ability to do is become that catalyst to get you to take that crucial first step and potentially keep you engaged. Right? So if you have someone like me, if you know you're working with someone like me or a trainer, or you have a favorite class that you go to every week, that is a sense of accountability, right? You're gonna check in with your trainer, you know you've got that 7 o'clock class that you love to take, you're gonna go there, there's that sense of accountability. But if you don't have that, if you can't maybe afford a personal trainer, or you know, you don't like group classes, things like this are, you know, on their own, a great motivating tool to keep you engaged. You know, whether that's the data, whether you're like a data geek and you're like, I want to know every calorie that I'm eating throughout the day, I want to know how many steps I'm taking and how that's translating to calories burned, or if you want that sense of community. And I think that, you know, that's my two cents on it.
I think that's
where
it.
I will say, though, that the one stumbling block that I've seen with these devices is that when there's too much going on, right? You know, when there's too much going on and there's too much to deal with, what happens is you run into this paralysis. It's like, too much shit, I can't know. Shut the computer, I don't want anything to do with it. You burn out, right?
There is the keep it simple thing.
Keep it simple.
Dan was saying, which is me, I'm not going to type in what I ate today, and I want people to write their food down, but they now have voice activation. They're working on like, yes, I had oatmeal with berries, with a latte. It was coffee. It was skim, or it was almond, right? If you can say it and you didn't have to type that out, that's pretty good, right?
It becomes too cumbersome. It leads to burnout. It's like diving into an over-involved fitness program, going hot and heavy, you know, full throttle for the first 5 days, and you're not going to maintain that pace. It's like a sprint. Eventually, you need to rest, and if you've gone overboard, you're going to completely fall off the ship. So I think it seems like your products have found a nice, healthy, approachable medium.
It seems that definitely the engagement piece is critical. And just like what Zumba and some of those kind of cool classes and some of your classes have done for fitness, they've made it more engaging, they've made it more entertaining. I think that's what some of the devices do as well. You know, with the Basis device, we spent quite a bit of extra time and extra money really figuring out how to make this entertaining, how to make it something that's fashionable. You see the device on my wrist right now. This is what I wear to the office.
Hot. That's hot. You guys, we wanted to have some questions. Does anybody have a question burning on their mind? Are you just fascinated and can't wait to run out and buy them? Okay. Yes.
I just want to say it's great to see a health plan, a payer, as a lead sponsor of an organization like this. I think there's huge potential for digital health to help manage chronic illnesses and improve outcomes. I'm wondering your thoughts on, you know, why, what is the hesitation, other than the fact that health plans are, by definition, risk averse. They're managers of risk. What do you see as the main stumbling block, and when are we going to go over that cusp where we're going to see health plans, the ones that really control the purse strings in the healthcare marketplace, really start making larger investments in digital health and in mHealth?
Yeah, I think it's a great question. It's definitely a cultural change. So to your point around risk aversion, what we're doing at Aetna, CarePass in of itself, we've had to break a lot of molds to get what we've done, get the green light. And I think you'll see more and more of it. there are other carrier insurance plans that have announced intentions and efforts in digital health. I think the key thing is consumer engagement. So back to the point that Adam was making, Nadeem was making, if the consumers flock, engage, and you're seeing real engagement with the underlying tools, there is so much potential, to your point, on tying that data to better health, and that's what insurance companies care about. If I can find a way to engage you and keep you healthy, I am completely invested in that, and I'll make more investment in that.
We have 1 minute to wrap up, so we're gonna take your question. Thank you.
I like your shirt.
Yeah. Oh, thank
Pretty
you.
Pretty awesome. It says, train like a beast, look like a beauty, and she wears it well.
Oh, thank you, thank you. I have a question, which is, where do you see the future for this space? Because with the proliferation of all of these kinds of community, you've got Spark people, you've got MyFitnessPal, LiveStrong, CarePass, and others, is it gonna go niche, like I am a 30 to 40 year old woman who is this much overweight, this is my community? Or do you think it's gonna go more CarePass, where it's, more CarePass, where it's like, okay, we're all gonna go to one place, and then you'll help us find where we belong in the 20 apps that you're linked with?
Yeah, that's a great question for everyone on the panel. My perspective on it is, there is different needs for different folks, and so the niche solutions absolutely are key. You see some of the niche solutions broadening, trying to answer other things and extending beyond their sweet spot. What we want to do is really serve it as an advisor. So that service that sits on top and can help you understand which tool might be most appropriate, but we're not going to be the niche tool, to your point. And so I think niche tools absolutely have to exist, particularly when you think about the mobile form factor. Folks want to get in and out. It has to be convenient. And as Adam was saying earlier, you know, you can have a very sophisticated tool, but if it's not simple, if it's not convenient, you'll lose me. It doesn't matter.
But you know, I was just going to say, but if you had what I liked about what you did was you could have United Healthcare, you could have Blue Cross, yeah. Whatever. They're still willing to take your data and work with it. It's not like, oh, I'm Aetna, there's nothing else. You know,
right.
It's cool.
Because this is great, this answer. I've got a community called The Lifestylista, and in a few months it's grown to 60,000 women. It's very multicultural, and I can see the niche has found, it's made itself. I didn't deliberately talk to one group. And I'm like, I feel like I want to do tracker meets app meets synced website. You know, like Facebook meets, kind of like Spark People Fitness, you know, MyFitnessPal meets Facebook. Now, is it too niched to actually deal with a particular, you know, create that kind of community and infrastructure, but for a very small niche?
Well, I think that's exactly what's going to happen. I mean, you see it with the Facebook community and what's happening post-Facebook. It's going to niche out. And I think exactly what, you know, I think the ideal situation and where we're going with this industry, at least from my perspective, is kind of like the Amazon recommendations. You know, the more sensors that are out there, the more data that you provide, the more you'll be able to be recommended, whether it might be the fitness class you take or the movie you should watch at night. You know, the more data that you're tracking and providing, the better your life is going to be based on recommendations.
Yeah, we live that right now. We've got more than 10,000 teams on our site. Almost all of them are member created. So it's like 10,000 little niches already. So yes, definitely.
And we do have to wrap it up, but I will say this. Insurance companies want to know what you're doing because, let's say this, if you want your Group X class covered, you have to show that you went. So people know that exercise is great, and I've heard this, and I think Virgin America launched one a long time ago where it was like they just had these people wear these little trackers at the gym, and they had a little blood pressure cuff thing to check and whatever. But that was going to a healthcare, that was going to an insurance company. But it's like, they didn't put your name down. They just said, you know, 1,000 people checked today, you know, their BMI was this, their blood pressure was this, they took a Group X class or a strength training class, or they were on the elliptical or whatever. That's the data these companies need, because we're not going to get our stuff covered if we don't show them we're not going. You know what I mean? So it kind of stands to reason we do have to give up a little bit of that privacy, even though it's not your social security number. You know what I mean? So anyway, you guys are great. Thank you so much. These guys are around if you have more questions. Maybe they'll go mill around and hang out so you guys can learn more, but we have to leave the stage for somebody else. So thank you so very much.
Thanks for coming.
Thanks, thank you.
And I'm teaching a wave shape class. When is it? At 3 o'clock. Yeah, it's a new like surf-inspired workout that I created. over
there. There's also in the in the room right there, we're going to be DJing. DJ Eric Sharp is in the crowd right now.
Love
and
it.
He's going to do a BioBeats DJ show.
Awesome.
In a little bit.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks for coming.
Yeah.